Hello, 9th standard children. This is continuation of our video 7 where we are going to learn revise question wise pattern for chapter 6 tissues. We will continue as we have done in video 7 that you should know about the way of writing creative questions and hard questions we are saying, all those way we have to continue. Okay, then we will continue this slide presentation, revision topic, right? Hello, we will continue the session. Now follow the question answers. This is only you will get an idea, as we call it as a creative question or hard questions we are saying, that only we are continuing. Okay, so first example now, open ended question actually it vandu or competitive exam porva kuda they can make use of these questions. Okay, so which plant tissue provides both mechanical strength as well as flexibility? Answer is polenchyma. As we know that படிச்சோம் ப்ரீவியஸ் வீடியோ செஷன்ல ஆஸ் கொலன்கைமா இஸ் அ சிம்பிள் பர்மனன்ட் டிஷ்யூ இட் ப்ரொவைட்ஸ் போத் மெக்கானிக்கல் ஸ்ட்ரென்த் ஆஸ் வெல் அஸ் ஃபிளெக்சிபிலிட்டி தென் வாட் கெமிக்கல் சப்ஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் டெபாசிட்டட் இன் தி செகண்டரி வால் இட் இஸ் லிக்னின் தென் நேம் தி பிளான்ட் டிஷ்யூ விச் ஷோ த ஃபாலோயிங் ஃபீச்சர் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் லிவிங் செல்ஸ் வித் த திக்கனிங் அண்ட் கிவ்ஸ் மெக்கானிக்கல் சப்போர்ட் Dead cell with thickening, again mechanical support and made up of living cell containing green color. Answer on the A. Colenchyma, B. Sclerenchyma, C. Parenchyma. The next one, what is skeletal connective tissue? It on the zoology portion. It render me mixture from plant tissues and animal tissues mixed. So understand the questions carefully. Skeletal connective tissue is a tissue which forms the endoskeleton of the body of vertebrates. It includes bones and cartilage. The function is to support the body musculature, give a definite shape to the body and protect the vital organs as brain, ear, heart, lungs. Questions paathukko and in a readout you can just go through the questions. What is a synapse? It is present in the neuron. The nerve endings are called neuron. Otherwise, we say the junction between terminal part of one axon and the dendrites of the adjacent neuron. Then name the protein found in white fiber and yellow fiber. It is collagen. And collagen is found as a white fiber and elastin is as a yellow fiber. As connective tissue, as we know, it is a connective tissue proper la areolar and adipose tissue padichirukom la previous session padichom la previous video la adhe maari adula and the areolar tissue it is formed of yellow fibers and white fibers then microvilli it increases the absorptive surface area of the intestine then medullary sheath again it is present in neuron it is present in neuron as outer neuron the axon formed of two layers outer dendron outer neurilemma and inner myelin sheath that medullary sheath is covering the nerve fibers actually it insulates the nerve fiber and prevents leakage of ions I hope you understand the next one is some figure based question identify the animal tissue represented alongside it is labeling vandu the diagram is squamous epithelium where labeling A it is squamous epithelium 1 cytoplasm 2 nucleus 3 cement base na that be the joining two cells then fourth one basement membrane I hope you are following. The next one, B la vandu, it protects the underlying body parts such as mouth cavity, skin, nose, alveoli, etc. This squamous epithelium protects the underlying body parts such as mouth, mouth cavity, skin, nose and alveoli. I hope you understand. Then observe the next diagram. It is the forearm, actually it is the upper arm with the, otherwise we say it is upper limb. Adha vandu upper arm forearm, the upper arm forearm and the muscles this area. So here the labeling, first one it is tendon, label A, first one it is tendon, second one it is muscle, second one it is just we say muscle, third labeling ligament, third labeling ligament, and fourth one is bone. So I repeat, first one labeling tendon, second labeling muscle, third ligament, and fourth one is the bone. I hope you understand. Then next question, mention the difference between 1 and 3. 1 and 3 na enada tendon and ligament illa kuduthirukkenu, see table 3.10 la irukku. Actually tendon it is attaching the muscle to bone, whereas ligaments will muscle will attach bone to bone. That is the difference. I hope you could follow this. Yeah, tendon will attach muscles to bones, ligaments will attach bone to bone. I hope you understand. Then question number 12, again observe the diagram. The given diagram is neuron or nervous tissue, and label the parts marked. First one it is dendrite, second one central cyton or cell body, and third one is axon. I repeat, first one dendrite, second cyton or cell body, third one axon. Then where it is located? Mainly it is located in the brain and spinal cord, but any nervous tissue, any part of the nervous system, it is formed of neuron or the nerve cell. But here it is given as brain and spinal cord, but actually it is present in the whole nervous system. I hope you understand. So this is for the given diagram. Then question 13, identify the tissue and label the parts. What type of tissue it occurs in the body? As any question, as it is a muscular tissue, actually it is a cardiac muscle. Muscle tissues are of three types: annular, skeletal muscle or striated or voluntary muscle, second one involuntary or smooth muscle, and third one it is cardiac muscle. This cardiac muscle is present only in the heart, and this cardiac muscle, it is having a special type of this special type, because it is capable of initiating the heartbeat, the rhythmicity it is capable of initiating. That is the salient feature, unique feature. Okay, and it is the difference vandu enna cardiac muscle vandu, it has branches that is called intercalated disc, whereas it resembles the voluntary muscle, skeletal muscle with the striations and nucleus, but it is different from that. With the striations are not bright as we say, and it has many branches. Those striations with the branches and the branching irukkadunala, it is having intercalated disc. In the cartoon pathi point ala adha intercalated disc. I hope you could follow this. Okay? So here it is a muscular tissue, cardiac muscle. Labeling: 1 sarcoplasm, 2 intercalated disc, 3 nucleus. Then third question, this tissue is cardiac muscle which is involuntary in nature. Then it is found in the wall of the heart of vertebrate. vertebrate heartland it is present. I hope you understand. Then third question 14, identify the given figure. It is LS of shoot, where the longitudinal section of a shoot apex, where it gives the position of the meristematic plant tissues. As so I illustrate location of meristematic tissues in plants, labeling apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristem. Labeling apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristem. Are you clear? So this is longitudinal section of the shoot apex. The next one, it is apical meristem. It is responsible for the growth of root, shoot, branches and leaves. And lateral meristem is responsible for increase in girth of stem and root. Girth na thickness chulukkain. Girth of stem and root. And lateral meristem chulukkain. Labeling on the apical meristem function chulukkain. I hope you are able to follow this. Then question 15. Identify the plant tissue given the figure. Label the parts. It is a simple parenchyma tissue, and parenchyma is a living tissue. It is a simple parenchyma tissue. It is a living tissue. Then it is labeling 1 cytoplasm, 2 nucleus, 3 vacuole, 4 intercellular spaces. I repeat, 1 cytoplasm, 2 nucleus, 3 vacuole and 4 intercellular spaces. I hope you understand. So this is for the simple parenchyma tissue. Now what is the main function? The main function of parenchyma is the storage of food. The main function of parenchyma is the storage of food. I hope you understand. Next one. Why is blood considered to be a connective tissue? Answer vandu, blood is considered as connective tissue because during circulation it passes through all the organs of the body, and in doing so it connects different tissues and organs of the body. I repeat, blood is considered as a liquid connective tissue. During circulation, it passes through all the organs of the body, and in doing so, it connects the different tissues and organs of the body. Are you clear? Then question 17, what will happen if apical meristem is damaged or cut? What will happen if apical meristem is damaged or cut? As apical meristems are present in at the tips of angular plane, root, shoot, branches and leaves. Apical meristems are found at the tips of root, shoot, branches and leaves. They form a growing parts of the root and stem. If they are damaged or cut, the growth in length of the part will cease to occur, will stop growing. So if this part is cut, the growth will be stopped. Question 18. What will happen if bone marrow is destroyed? Bone marrow produces blood cells. NLM blood cells, RBC and WBC. RBC, red blood corpuscle, WBC, white blood corpuscles. If bone marrow is destroyed, WBC and RBC and platelets will not be formed. So what will happen if bone marrow is destroyed? It produces the blood cells, RBC, WBC and blood platelets. So if the bone marrow is destroyed, these three cells will not be formed. Answer. Then question 19, what will happen if all the blood platelets are removed? Ella remove panna mudiyuma ana koranjidana numbers if it is reduced, then it is responsible for release of the protein thromboplastin necessary for clotting of blood at the site injury. So the absence of blood platelets, blood clotting will not occur after injury and bleeding will continue from the wound. Sure, yeah? This will finally cause the injured person, leading to this is what will happen if all the blood platelets are removed. Sure, yeah? Then usual exemplar questions, adhula and actual creative questions, adhu unakku therinjirukkum. Which structure protects the body against the invasion of parasites? Na, it is plant tissues. Le, epidermis. Outermost layer is called epidermis. So that epidermis is the outer protective layer of plant body, which does not allow the parasites to gain entry into plant's internal tissues due to absence of intercellular spaces, thick outer wall, deposition of cutin and fats in the cuticle covering epidermis, silica and other deposition. So epidermis outermost layer in root, stem and leaf. In the cell wall materials irukkadanaala, the features irukkadanaala, edala no intercellular space, the outer wall is thick, deposition of cutin and wax irukkadanaala, it will not be affected by the parasites. Next question, animals of colder region and fishes of cold water have thicker layer of subcutaneous fat. Animal tissue. In animals, subcutaneous fat function as insulating layer. In animals, subcutaneous fat acting as insulating layer that prevents heat loss from the body in cold environment. So, animals in cold areas and fishes of cold water possess thick layer of subcutaneous fat. Fat also functions as reserve food during period of food scarcity. So, it is mentioned in animals, subcutaneous fat functions as insulating layer that prevents heat loss from the body in cold environment. So animals in cold areas and fishes of cold water possess thick layer of subcutaneous fat. Are you clear? The next one, it is match the following முன்னாடி நான் ஒரு பேஜ் விட்டுட்டேன் ஆனா புரிஞ்சுக்கோ ஜஸ்ட் லிசன் பண்ணிக்க அப்புறம் இந்த பேஜுக்கு வரேன் டிரா அண்ட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃப்ளோயம் ஒரு ஸ்லைடு விட்டுட்டு நீ கடுத்தது பார்த்துக்கோ டிரா முந்தின ஸ்லைடு வந்து எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் பார்த்துக்கோ தென் ஐ கம் டு திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் 6 டிரா அண்ட் ஐடென்டிஃபை டிஃப்ரெண்ட் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃப்ளோயம் என்னெல்லாம்னாக்க சீவ் டியூப் கம்பானியன் செல் phloem parenchyma phloem fibers. I repeat, sieve tube companion cell phloem parenchyma phloem fibers. இது வந்து டயகிராம் நான் உங்களுக்கு கொடுத்திருக்கேன் இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் வீடியோ செஷன்ல வரைஞ்சிருக்கோம் அது மாதிரி இல்லைன்னா நம்ம கியூபிலையும் கொடுத்துருக்கேன் அந்த மாதிரி யூ ஹாவ் டு ட்ரா ஓகே தென் க்வெஸ்சன் 7 ரைட் ட்ரூ ஆர் ஃபால்ஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் 7 One minute. I'm sorry. Correct. I'll continue with this slide. Match the item of the column A and B. Match the item of column A and column B. It is the animal tissues. Striated squamous epithelium. Column B is actually found in the skin. Striated squamous epithelium, it is found in the skin. Then striated muscle It is a skeletal muscle. Correct. Striated muscle. It is also known as skeletal muscle, voluntary muscle. Then third one, fluid connective tissue. It is the blood. Blood is a fluid connective tissue. Right. Then filling space inside the organ. Filling the space inside the organ, it is alveolar connective tissue. Actually, areolar connective tissue. The filling the space, filling patko areolar. Then adipose tissue, subcutaneous layer. Adipose tissue, subcutaneous layer. Then last, surface of joints, it is cartilage. Surface of joint is the cartilage. So I repeat, stratified squamous epithelium, skin, striated muscle, skeletal muscle, fluid connective tissue, blood, filling the space, it is areolar connective tissue, adipose on the subcutaneous, and surface of joints, it is cartilage. The next matching, again it on the botany, parenchyma. Question 4, matching parenchyma, it gives buoyancy. Buoyancy in aquatic plants, helpful in this tissue present mostly in aquatic plants or water plant. It is helpful for the floating on the surface of water, not the buoyancy. Then colenchyma, it is having a localized thickening. Normal and the thickening will be confined to the corners of the cell. Another localized thickening. Then parenchyma, it is thin walled cells, permanent tissue, sclerenchyma, photosynthesis, carbon fixation. So I repeat, parenchyma, buoyancy, colenchyma, localized thickening, parenchyma, thin walled cells, permanent tissues, tissue, sclerenchyma, photosynthesis, carbon fixation. Chariya. Then name the different components of xylem. Enalam chunne, xylem tracheas, xylem vessels, xylem fibers, and xylem parenchyma. I repeat, xylem tracheas, xylem vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. Xylem fiber, it is also known as wood fiber. And the diagram already put to Kenya. And the Munadi Idila, other one you can go through. Cubilium. Now, next one, Ipala Napalishan. Draw and identify different elements of phloem. Apparition Mari. It is sieve tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fibers. Then question 7, write true or false, epithelial tissue, true or false, epithelial tissue is protective in animal body, it is true, lining of blood vessels, lungs of alveoli and kidney tubules are made up of epithelial tissue, that is also true, then epithelial cells have lot of intercellular spaces, false, epithelial layer is permeable, true, epithelial layer layers do not allow regulation of material, it is false. So I repeat, A true, B true, C false, D true, and E false. Okay, then differentiate between voluntary and involuntary muscle, that you can go through. I don't self-explanatory. Voluntary muscles function as per direction or control of our will. Brain cannot stop them or start them. They get fatigued after some time. We get tired. ஒரு அரை மணி நேரம் ஓடிண்டே இருந்தீங்க அப்புறம் நம்மளால ஓட முடியாது. அதான் if we can stop it. அதான் fatigue after some time. Example, skeletal or striated muscle. Whereas involuntary, they function on their own independent conscious of will. Brain cannot stop or start them. They do not get fatigued. Example, unstriated or smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. I hope you could follow this. இது நான் வந்து இதுலயும் கொடுத்துருக்கேன், கியூபிலே இருக்கு, தட் யூ கேன் கோ த்ரூ. Then question 9, differentiate the following activities on the basis of voluntary as V and involuntary as IV. Voluntary as V and involuntary as IV. In the jumping of frog, it is voluntary. It is under the control of our willpower. So jumping of frog, voluntary. Pumping of heart, involuntary. Writing with hand, voluntary. And movement of chocolate in your intestine. Chocolate, it will move inside our intestine. So movement of chocolate in your intestine, it is involuntary. Sorry? So this is how the creative question will be there. I hope you could follow this. Yeah? The next one. Fill in the blanks. Lining of blood vessels made up of squamous epithelium. Lining of blood vessels made up of squamous epithelium. I repeat, lining of blood vessels made up of squamous epithelium. Lining of small intestine, columnar epithelium. Lining of small intestine, columnar epithelium. Then lining of kidney tubule, cuboidal epithelium. Lining of kidney tubule, cuboidal epithelium. Then epithelial cells with the cilia are found in respiratory tract. I repeat, squamous epithelium, columnar epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and respiratory tract. That's the answer for fill up. Then next, fill in the blanks. Cork cells possess on their walls that makes them impervious to gases and water. Cork cells possess dash on their walls that makes them impervious to gases and water. The cell wall material, suberin. Cell wall material, it is suberin. Then dash have tubular cells with perforated walls and are living in nature. Tubular cells with the perforated walls and the tracheids and vessels are perforated walls and are living in nature. In the sieve tube, then see bones possess hard matrix composed of dash and dash. Bone is formed of the mineral calcium and phosphorus. Bone is formed of calcium and phosphorus. Right? Then question 12. Why epidermis is important for the plant? It protects the root, stem and leaf. It is formed of thick layer with the cuticle and wax, preventing excess transpiration and also invading of parasites. Then fill in the blanks. Dash forms the complex tissue, xylem and phloem. Then stomata have God cells. Cells of cork contain a chemical called suberin. Then sclerenchyma, husk of coconut. The husk of coconut, it is made up of sclerenchyma tissue. Then xylem and phloem, both are conductive tissue. Then colenchyma gives flexibility in plants. Then xylem transports water and minerals from the soil. Transports water and minerals from the soil. செவ்வி ஃப்ளோயம் ட்ரான்ஸ்போர்ட் ஃபுட் ஃப்ரம் த லீவ்ஸ் டு அதர் பார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பிளான்ட் ஃப்ளோயம் ட்ரான்ஸ்போர்ட் ஃபுட் ஃப்ரம் த லீவ்ஸ் டு அதர் பார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பிளான்ட் ஸோ ஐ ரிப்பீட் த பில்லர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் ஜைலம் அண்ட் ஃப்ளோயம் செகண்ட் ஸ்டொமேட்டா தேர்ட் சூபரின் ஃபோர்த் ஸ்க்ளீரன்கைமா E. xylem and phloem, F. colenchyma, G. water and minerals, H. vandu food and leaves. I hope you are able to follow this. Then last page, it is water hyacinth floats on water surface. Explain. Water hyacinth na, nama aika niyanu or hydrophyte parichukonla, ahaya thamarai na, nama aathu thannila nariya irukume amala chedi na, adha water hyacinth, right? Water hyacinth, Icanea, has spongy petioles which enclose a lot of air in its parenchyma. Water hyacinth has spongy petiole which enclose a lot of air in its parenchyma. Air makes the plant lighter than water, so that is able to float on water surface. I hope you understand. Then difference between sclerenchyma and parenchyma நம்ம textbookல இருக்கு இது ஒரு lengthy answer நான் சின்னதாவும் நம்ம QB ல இருக்கு அது with that you can do it well அதே மாதிரி அடுத்ததுல வந்து long answers that we have discussed in the question bank that you can learn சரியா so with this video session is we are completing so you will prepare well for the without wasting the time sit and revise go through all these questions இந்த மாதிரி தான் pattern நமக்கு இன்னைக்கு நீ எழுத போற test ல வரும் என்னன்னா மாதிரி choose the correct answer fill in the blanks true or false match the following அப்புறம் the analogy நான் இதுல கொடுக்கல ஏன்னா நம்ம ஏற்கனவே பண்ணிருக்கோம் complete the given analogy then one word answer டயக்ராம் கொடுத்து அதில் கொஸ்டின் இருக்கும் அந்த மாதிரி டைப் ஆஃப் கொஸ்டின்ஸு யூ வில் ஸ்டடி வெல் ரிவைஸ் வெல் யூ ஆல் த பெஸ்ட் தேங்க்யூ